ma'am, can I pass through? Thank you.
Yes, yes. Brilliant. And
when we speak about the word fundamentalist, are we giving it a negative or a positive connotation?
It comes as negative.
Shout that louder.
Negative.
Okay. So what I'm going to do now is read you the Oxford Dictionary's definition to just that word, fundamentalist.
Sir, can you just tell us, should people who live Islam, should they be killed? Sir, people who live Islam, can you just tell me if they should be killed? Sir, you are asking the questions about the fundamentalist. You are asking the question about the fundamentalist. So I am asking you the simple question. People who should, who live Islam, should they be killed? Sir, people who live Islam, should they be killed?
Deuteronomy 13, stone and apostate in your own house. Don't be a hypocrite.
Sir, people who live Islam, should they be killed? You said you are talking about the fundamentalist. You are talking about the fundamentalist. I am asking you a question. Did you become a Christian? It is in the church, guys. It is in the church. Did you become a Christian? Are you one of the apostates? Why I didn't see your baptism book? So, now, answer my question. According to Islam, people who live in Islam, should they be killed?
That's a good question. Should people who live in Islam be killed? That's a question.
Deuteronomy 13, stone the apostate in your own house.
You're the speaker.
Sir, should people be killed who live in Islam? Can you answer the question, sir? Are you just coming here for your telly? Answer the question, please.
For the barat that we face.
Answer the question, please.
He will answer. He's afraid.
And we know what Islam teaches about the kuffar. We know what Islam teaches about the kuffar.
Look at it. This is.
We know what Islam teaches about the kuffar. Can you just tell us what should happen to the kuffars? What should happen to the kuffars? What should happen to the kuffars? What should happen to the kuffars?
Why is it?
What should happen to? It is fundamentalist.
It is on topic. It is on topic.
I want to answer my question. I am called Kuffar. Should Kuffar be killed? Should Kuffar be
Muhammad avoiding the question?
Should Kuffar be killed?
Let me ask the question. If we leave Islam, will you be killed? That's the question.
Good.
That's the question we want to know. Because there's some Muslims here who may be on the verge of leaving Islam. Will they be killed? Yes or no? That's the question we want to ask. You know, we're not asking, potentially, we're asking what happens.
There's ex-Muslims in the park.
So we have a
Muslim.
We have a Muslim.
You call him Kuffar.
The word of Allah.
What does Islam teach us about the kuffars? Should I be killed?
No, what does Allah say?
What does the Bible say about Gentile women like yourself, cause you dogs? Shush.
What does Allah say?
What does Islam teach us about people who live the religion of Islam?
Stone the apostate in your own house. If your child needs Christianity, you have to kill them. Shush.
Why are you afraid to tell me what Allah says?
Because they're afraid.
You're afraid to talk about Allah.
They're
hiding behind the Arabic again.
Is David a prophet?
So Islam only about Arabic?
Yes.
Okay. Did Muhammad have sex with a 9-year-old child? He got silenced.
That's got nothing to do with anything.
What would they even got to do with it for you, Joker? Alright, okay, okay. No, but
you're
trying to
be
13. Sir, can you just tell me what should happen to the people who live the religion of Islam? Topic is about the fundamentalist. I am asking the question about the fundamentalist. I don't care. I am here. I want answer to my question. I want answer to my question. It's all.
It's nothing relevant. Look at me. I'm trying to listen. Stop interrupting.
He's not speaking. I am asking simply.
Yes, we're waiting for you to shut up.
Okay.
We're waiting for you to shut up.
What does Islam teach us for those who live the religion of peace?
If you leave Islam, you will be killed.
But when they tolerate, then seize them and kill them wherever you find them and take not from among them any helper. Wherever you find them, wherever you find them, if they turn away, then seize them and kill them. Seize them and kill them. So, what does Islam teach us for those who live the religion of Islam? Is that what it teaches?
No, come on, how would you, man? Don't be
shy. It is very, very clear. It is very clear that Islam destroyed you.
Speaking like a child, you have to act like a child to you, innit?
What does Islam teach us for those who live the religion of Islam? I'm asking a question. Ask me a question. Sir, what does Islam teach us for those who live the religion of peace?
I will stand here until I deliver my message.
Good.
Sir, what does Islam teach for those who live the religion of Islam? You were talking about the fundamentalists, so I am asking you a very simple question on the topic. What does Islam teaches for those who live the religion of Islam? I am waiting for an answer.
That's cow sperm.
I am asking simple questions on the topic. What does Islam teach us about those who live the religion of peace? What does Islam teach us for those who live the religion of peace?
Okay, thank you. Muhammad will not answer the question. It's a very clear and very explicit question. It's in the Quran. From Muhammad Tawheed, the Sheikh of the Speaker's Corner, who stands up there in his room.
The what of Speaker's Corner?
The Sheikh of Speaker's Corner. With his Guidance Avenue YouTube channel. We're asking you a question. You're the speaker. If somebody leaves Islam, what is the punishment or what is the consequence of one person
Was David a prophet?
So, I am asking this.
Had sex with a 9-year-old.
That is disgusting.
That was despicable.
Disgusting. Disgusting. Prophet Muhammad so far a bit disgusting. So, I am asking my question again on the topic of fundamentalists. So,
the topic is
the fundamentalist. Let's see. What is the fundamentalist view on Islam? Thank you. So, what happens to people who live the religion of peace? What happens to the people who live the religion of Islam, sir?
Come on. Answer the question.
In English?
In English?
Yeah.
What happens to people who live the Islam. Sir, you can mock, you can bully, but my question still stands. What happens to people who live the religion of Islam? I can see, as you do not answer my question, Khurus, Islam is a false religion.
After I give my message, I will listen to you.
Islam is not defendable. I am asking the question on the topic you were speaking. So what happens to people? What happens to people when they leave Islam?
Go there. Go and make your own self.
Okay. So since Islamic Dawah Team does not answer my question, let me read it from the Quran. They would disbelieve. As they disbelieve, so you would be alike. So do not take from among them aliens until they immigrate for the cause of Allah. But if they turn away,
your voice is what slapped me instead of giving that voice.
If they turn away, wherever you find them, take not from wherever you find them.
Don't talk over a man, your Bible says.
Seize them and kill them.
Wallahi, what's your point? I didn't listen to one
word. So he's talking about the fundamentalist. I am asking, what is the fundamentalist view on for those who live the religion of Islam?
Hatun, can I finish my talk?
No, because I'm asking the question. I am asking the question.
Don't talk over a man.
When did you get baptized?
Don't talk over a man.
When did you get baptized?
Why did Jesus get baptized?
As a Christian, I don't have right to preach in the church, which is in housemates. I cannot preach among Christian brothers in the church. If today you tell me to shut up, show me your baptism pool. When did you become a Christian? When did you get baptized? If you have just shush and answer the basic question. Basic question still stands. What is the fundamentalist view for those who live the religion of Islam?
Why are you abusing men with your voice?
So are you going to answer?
No,
there's
no way.
There's only one honest Muslim.
Hey, side man, you are side man.
Shut up.
What happened?
Let me help you out. Fundamentalist Islam, which means also radical Muslims. Radical Muslims are dangerous. Muslims who have been destroyed by Islam. So radical Islam is dangerous because radical Islam tells you if people leave the religion of Islam, they should be killed. Therefore, radical Islam is dangerous, and you are the radical Muslim who is dangerous to the world, sir, because Quran is dangerous. Sir, can you just tell me what does Islam teach? Why Islam teaches people should be killed?
It's war. If you come to fight me, I will fight you. It's simple.
It doesn't say
to
fight. Yes, those who turn away from the religion of Islam, those who turn away from the religion of Islam should be killed. That's my simple question. Is this radical view dangerous to the mankind? Answer is yes. Radical Islam is dangerous for mankind because teachings of Islam is dangerous.
Have you been killed? Are you an ex-Muslim?
That's not your business, sir.
You're an ex-Muslim. You're saying ex-Muslim. Get killed. Why are you alive? Why are you alive?
Why are you alive?
Why are you alive? We are meant to kill you. You're an ex-Muslim. Okay. You're an ex-Muslim. Why are you still alive?
Why haven't you practiced your Quran? Why haven't you practiced your Quran?
What that Quran says?
How?
Seize them, kill them. Whoever gives up the religions of Islam, kill them. Whoever leaves the religions of Islam, kill them. Because of that. Because of that. Fundamentalist Muslims are dangerous. Because of that. Radical Islam, radical Muslims.
The priest says, do not talk over a man.
Yes.
You're not listening to your priest.
I cannot talk.
Kill people who do not listen to their priest.
I cannot preach over men in the church. In the church. Is this church? Are you Christian? No. Are you Christian? No. Then shush. Since you're not Christian, you need to repent. Since you are not Christian, you need to repent. So, overall point I am making is very simple.
You're good.
Overall point I am making is very simple. That is fundamentalist Muslims at Speaker's Corner. That is radical Muslims at Speaker's Corner. They are dangerous. They are dangerous because of this book. Teachings of the Quran is dangerous. Teachings of Muhammad is dangerous. Therefore, people who are identify themselves as radicals, follow the book and follow the man, are dangerous for mankind, guys. Yes, sir.
Do you want me to show you? Do you want me to show you how many verses in the Bible talk about killing?
I said,
authorize you want to believe Islam, you said.
Apostates should be killed. Apostates should be killed.
Which book says that?
Quran 489. Sahih Bukhari says again, Muhammad said, Surah 489, and also Sahih Bukhari. Those are, again, you can see, special hecklers. Mean that lots of hecklers who has no answer to basic question. Simple question. I'm going to find those radical Muslims to see how radical teachings are dangerous for mankind.
Sorry, sir.
Space. Sir, why are you pushing me away?
Don't be physical with women.
Yes. Sir, why Islam is very dangerous? Sir, can you just tell me? Brother, just move. Sir, I am asking the question. Why Islam is dangerous?
Fundamentalist.
What? You are fundamentalist. Because of the teachings of Islam, you are dangerous, dangerous to mankind. Sir, can you tell us why Islam is dangerous? Sir, why Islam? Sir, why Islam is dangerous? Why those people don't even allow me to ask a question? Are you so scared of them?
Don't touch me. Don't touch me.
Sir, you are blocking.
Don't touch me.
You are blocking, sir.
No, I am not blocking you.
You know I am not touching you.
Don't touch me. Don't touch me.
You know I am not touching you.
He ignore you why you come here.
I am asking the question.
He ignore you why you come here.
I am asking the question.
He never come to you.
I am asking question.
No, he ignore you.
Respect yourself.
Respect yourself. If you have personality, respect
is
yourself.
A false religion.
Respect
because
yourself.
He knows Islam is a dangerous ideology. Islam. And he calls me Satan. And he. Sir, don't push me. Excuse me, don't push me. Sir, don't push me. Don't push me again.
Don't push
me. That is disgusting. That is disgusting. Sir, just move. Brother, just move. Sir, you push me. I'm trying to get in there, sir. Sir, disgusting. Islam is disgusting. Muslims are just pushing me back because Islamic Dawah Team doesn't know how to answer the basic question. I am Satan according to you. Do I look like a Muhammad? No, Muhammad is a Satan. I am not a Satan. Sir, can you just tell us? Sir, can you tell us? Sir, can you tell us why Islam is dangerous ideology?
Why
Islam is dangerous ideology? You can block me. You can block me. Don't touch me. Don't touch me. Don't touch me. So, sir, why Islam is dangerous ideology? You can hide from me on the day of judgment. You are not allowed to hide from Lord Jesus. Disgusting. This is what Islam does to people. Islam destroys the people. Islam destroys the people. Islam destroys the people. Islam destroys the people. Why is Islam dangerous ideology? Islamic Dawah Team is all right with that. Therefore, Islam is a dangerous ideology. Islam is a dangerous ideology. It is a dangerous ideology. It still doesn't change the fact that Islam is a dangerous ideology. Why it is dangerous ideology? Here's the two examples. Islam destroys the mankind. It is Islam which distorts the mankind. It is the teachings of the Quran takes the brain of mankind. It is the teachings of Muhammad and the Quran destroys the mankind. Why fundamentalist Muslims are dangerous to mankind, sir? My simple question. Why fundamentalist Muslims are dangerous to mankind?
There was order before you came and created chaos.
It is dangerous ideology, sir. It is dangerous ideology. Sir, why Islam is dangerous ideology? Why is Islam dangerous ideology? Why is Islam dangerous ideology? Why Islam is dangerous ideology? Even it destroys young people's minds. It is very, very. Answer the question and then I'll go. Answer the question and I'll go away. I am asking the simple question. Answer the question and I will go away. Simple question. I'm not touching you. Don't takia. Don't do takia. Allah hates liars and you are one of them. Takia. Yet Allah is a liar. That's a different topic. Why is Islam dangerous ideology, sir? Why is Islam dangerous ideology? Why is Islam dangerous ideology? Why is Islam dangerous ideology? Just I am so scared. I am so scared that you have an answer to my question. Why is Islam dangerous ideology? Islam is a dangerous ideology. It is that dangerous, they don't even allow me to go and ask my question in the front. Why is Islam dangerous ideology? Why is Islam dangerous ideology? Why is Islam dangerous ideology? Why is Islam dangerous ideology. Why is I'm asking the question to him. No, I am asking the question to him now. I did ask my question to you. You all run away. Why Islam is a false religion? So, now